voice was very soft. Soon kids heard knocking and a voice at the door.
Open the door, dear children. Your mother is back and I have something for each of you.
But the wolf had unwittingly put his black paws on the windowsill.
You are not our mother. She doesn't have black paws. You are the wolf.
The wolf went to the baker.
I have hurt my feet. Put some dough on them.
After the baker had put some dough on his feet, the wolf went to the miller.
Put some flour on my feet.
The miller suspected that the wolf was up to no good, but when he hesitated, the wolf said he would eat him up. The miller put flour on the wolf's feet. The wolf hurried to the home of the enemy goat. Soon the kids heard knocking and a voice at the door.
Open the door, dear children. Your mother is back and I have something for each of you.
This time, when the kids saw the white feet on the door, they thought it was their mother. They opened the door. One wolf came in and tried to hide. One ran under the table, the second jumped into bed, the third hid in the oven, the fourth ran in the kitchen, the fifth went into the cupboard, the sixth hid in the washroom, the seventh hid in the tall clock table. But it was too late. The wolf had all ready swallowed each one except the seventh. He could not find in the clock case. He left. He lay down in the nearby meadow and began to snore. The nanny goat came home. The house was ruined. Tables and chairs were upside down. The washbowl was broken. The bed covers were torn from the bed. She called for her kids by each one's name. When she called her youngest name, she answered,
I'm here in the darkness, Mother.
Oh, my child, what has happened here?
Where are your brothers and sisters?
She and her youngest kid went outside. Soon they heard snoring in the meadow. They looked carefully at the sleeping wolf and saw movements in his belly.
Do you think that kids are still alive in the wolf?
Something is moving inside them, Mother.
She caught up